है ना।
टुडे वी विल लर्न द रूल 5। एक्चुअली वी वर लर्निंग अबाउट द रूल्स फॉर नेमिंग ऑफ एलिसाइक्लिक कॉम्पाउंड्स। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द फोर्थ रूल, नाउ वी विल लर्न अबाउट द फिफ्थ रूल। व्हाट डज द फिफ्थ रूल सेज? सो दिस फिफ्थ रूल सेज दैट इन सब्स्टिट्यूटेड साइक्लोअल्कीन्स, साइक्लोअल्कीन, व्हाट इज साइक्लोअल्कीन? Cycloalkene means the cyclic compound having double bond is said to be cycloalkene. This is cycloalkene. This is another cycloalkene. This is another cycloalkene. So like this. So these are said to be cycloalkenes. Then what is substituted cycloalkene? Suppose one hydrogen is replaced by any other atoms or group of atoms, then they are called as substituted cycloalkenes. So this is cyclopropene. It is a substituted cycloalkene. Sorry, it's a cycloalkene. If I attach some atoms like chlorine or else any group like this methyl group or else any functional group. So in all these cases, now these are said to be substituted alkenes. Okay, substituted alkenes. So now rule say 5 says that about the substituted alkenes. In substituted alkenes, okay, double bond is given the lowest possible number. For example, this is an alkene first. So now this is an alkene. See, remember that cycloalkene. So here, when double bond is present, when multiple bond is present, so one of the carbon will get number 1. The next carbon which is attached to the same double bond or else the same multiple bond, the next carbon will receive the next number. So this is the right number. Suppose if you give numbering like this, if you give number 1 to this one, so if you give number 2 this one, this is wrong. This is wrong way of representation. Remember that. So the double bonded carbons. So this is this carbon and this carbon. Both the carbons are involved in this double bond. So these double bonded carbons should get the subsequent numbers or else the the next number. Okay. The next number should be given to the other carbon atom which is attached to the same double bond. Okay, got it. So like this. So this is wrong numbering and this is right numbering. Okay, so now this is alkene, cycloalkene. In cycloalkenes, always remember that the double, if there is any double bond, then the two atoms which are attached to the double bond, so those two atoms will get the successive numbers. Okay, so like this. Right. So now this is alkene. This is not substituted alkene. Now this is substituted alkene because some other group is present. See, actually, if I draw a single line like this, it indicates that the other end it is having carbon atom. Okay, other end is having carbon atom. Now these are the six carbon atoms which are related to the ring, and this carbon atom is attached to the ring. So this is methyl group which is attached to this ring. Now this compound is said to be substituted cycloalkene. So in this case, in substituted cycloalkenes, double bond is given the lowest possible number. Double bond is given the lowest possible number. See, look here. So actually there is substitution on this carbon. Even this carbon is also substituted because double bond is there. So now these carbons should get the lowest possible number. Okay, then only the substituent will get the other number. Okay, suppose if I write 1 here, I have to write 2 here. Okay, right. So now, or else, if I write one here, I have to write two here. Okay. So now, which one is correct? So 1, 2, or 1, 2. Which one is correct way of representing? See, look here. This the next numbering. So which way of numbering is correct? It is depending upon the substituent. So numbering is done in such a way that the substituents get the lowest number. See, look here. I will take the same compound again, and I will give the numbering in another way. So here in this case, now I will give 1, 2. So in one case, I have given this carbon as second carbon, this carbon as first carbon. So now this is the first carbon, this is the second carbon. This will become third carbon, this will become fourth carbon, and this carbon will become fifth carbon, and this will become the sixth carbon. Now in this case, this is the first carbon, second carbon, and this carbon will become third carbon, this carbon will become fourth, this will become fifth, and this will become the sixth carbon. See now, so now this is substituent. Okay, so this rule says that numbering is done in such a way that the substituents get the lowest number. So now, which numbering is correct? This numbering or this numbering? Which numbering is correct? So this numbering is correct. No, not this numbering is correct. Why? Because if you give numbering in this way, the carbon which is bearing this substituent, it is getting fourth number, fourth. Look at fourth. But if you give numbering in this direction, so the carbon will get number 5. The locant carbon will get number 5. So which one is the lowest numbering? So if I give numbering in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I give numbering in this direction, then that is the correct numbering. So here, according to rule 5, so this is the correct numbering and this is wrong numbering. Okay. So in substituted cycloalkenes, double bond is given the lowest possible number. See, numbering always should be given to the double bond only, lowest number. So here also this carbon is the substituted, the carbon to which the substituent is attached, it is not getting the lowest numbering. So the double bonded carbons are getting lowest numbering. Okay, in substituted cycloalkenes, okay, double bond is given the lowest possible number. Okay, next, numbering is done in such a way that the substituents get the lowest number. So here, numbering the double bonded carbons, the other carbons are numbered here. So here in this way, the numbering is given, and in this compound, in this way, the numbering is given. So which numbering is correct? This numbering is correct by following this rule, because here the locant carbon is 4, but here the locant carbon is 5. So the locant carbon is 4 if I give numbering in this direction. So now hence this is the lowest locant, hence this is the correct way of numbering and this is the wrong way of numbering. These are same compounds, but I have given numbering in different fashions. So this method of numbering is correct and this is wrong. Okay, see, numbering is done in such a way that the substituent, so here this is a substituent, and the substituent attached to this carbon, so this carbon get the lowest number. Okay, so here it is getting 5. The same carbon, if I give in this way the numbering, the same carbon is getting 4 only. Hence the way in which the carbon gets number 4 number 4 is correct numbering when compared to the way by which the same carbon gets number 5. Okay, so this numbering is correct and this is wrong numbering. Right. So what is the name of this compound? So this is wrong way of numbering. Okay. What is the name of this compound? It is called as cyclobenzene. 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 Right? So I am rubbing it. I am rubbing these things. And even this is also wrong. Hence, I am rubbing this one. So what is the name of this one? So here on third carbon. On which carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4th carbon. On 4th carbon. On 4th carbon. The methyl, this is, if I simply draw this line like this, it indicates methyl group. Okay, so on fourth carbon, methyl group is present. Hence, the name of this one is 4-methyl. Okay, 4-methyl cyclohexene, 4-methyl cyclohexene is the correct name of this compound. Then what is the name of this compound? What is the name of this compound? See, double bond, so these two are the carbons to which the double bond is attached. So now give numbering. So which direction the numbering is correct? Numbering. See, again I am drawing the same compound. I will use different types of numbering. So in both the cases, so I will give number 1 to this carbon and 2 this carbon, and 3 to this carbon, 4, 5. Okay, and I will go in the reverse order. So this carbon 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So which one is correct numbering? See, numbering should be done in such a way that the locants should get lowest number. So here if I give numbering in this direction, so the locants will be 2 and 3. Second carbon is having substituent and third carbon is having substituent. Suppose if I give numbering in this direction, then the first carbon will have substituent and fifth carbon will have substituent. So the sum of the substituents is, sorry, sum of the locants is first carbon, one substituent is present, and on fifth carbon one substituent is present. So the sum of the locants is 6. But here in this case, so on second carbon substituent is present and third carbon substituent is present. So sum of the locant is 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. So in which case the sum of the locants is less? So in this case sum of the locants is less. Hence this way the numbering is correct. And this is wrong way of numbering. Okay. Right. So I am removing this one also. And as it is wrong, so I am removing this one also. So this is the correct way of numbering. Right. So this is the correct way of numbering as it is having lowest sum of the locants. Right. So now what is the name of this compound? What is the name of this compound? See, look here, on second carbon and third carbon, methyl groups are present. Hence the name of the carbon will go like this. So 2, 3 dimethyl. 2, 3 dimethyl cyclopent. This is 5 member ring. Hence cyclopent. Cyclopent. Okay, cyclopentene. Okay, right. Because there is a double bond. Hence I am mentioning it as cyclopentene. So this is the name of this compound. Right. I am rubbing this one also. Now let us see what is the name of this compound. What is the name of this compound? So first I will give the numbering. So in which direction I should give numbering? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or else. One, two, three, four, five, six. So which is the correct way? See, if I give numbering in this direction, so this is the first carbon, second carbon. So now finally, if I come, so now the locant is on sixth carbon. If I give numbering in this way, the same compound, if I give numbering in this way, so the third carbon will become the locant carbon. So hence, if I give numbering in this direction, as the locant position is least, lowest locant rule says that we have to give numbering in this direction and numbering should not be in this direction. Hence, this is wrong and this is right. Okay. As it is wrong, I am removing it off. It is right one. Now, I will write the name of this compound. What is the name of this compound? See, this is methyl group. Okay, so if I simply write a single dash, it indicates the other end is having carbon. So, how many carbons are there? So, one carbon is attached to this ring. So, on which carbon? So, on third carbon of this ring, on third carbon of this ring, so one carbon is present. Hence, the group, the substituent or else the side chain is methyl side chain. So, on which carbon the methyl side chain is present? On third carbon. Hence, 3-methyl, it is called as 3-methyl cyclohexene. So, this is the name of this compound. Right. So, in this way, rule 5 will tell about the numbering, how the numbering should be done when a substituent is present in cycloalkenes. Cycloalkenes. Now let us learn the sixth rule. Rule 6. It says that if functional group belongs to the ring, if a functional group belongs to the ring, if functional groups belongs to the ring, then the functional group is given lowest possible number, then the carbon of the ring to which the functional group is attached should get a lowest possible number. Okay, the functional group, okay, is given the lowest possible number or else lowest number. Okay, and the position of the and the position or else the numbering and the position or else number of the substituent, if there is substituent also along with the functional group, in that compound, in that cyclic compound, then the position of the substituent or even multiple bonds, if multiple bonds are present. Okay, so they are based on, so the either substituents or multiple bonds are present along with the functional group, then the numbering of substituent or multiple bond is based on what? Okay, is based on or else it depends on, based on means it depends on the functional group. It depends upon the functional group. So let us discuss with one example. Suppose let us take alcohol functional group. Let us see a compound with the alcohol functional group. See, look here, alcohol is present.